Okay, students, I am audible. Good morning, dear students. Good morning, dear students, I am audible. Okay, welcome to image processing class. Okay, so we are discussing module 4. So image segmentation, what we are discussing, isn't it? So image segmentation, what we are discussing. So segmentation is a process of extraction of region of interest. Means there may be several regions. Among them, we are requiring a particular region. So those region which satisfy the criteria based on a rule. So that particular region will be selected as a region of interest, and it will be extracted. So this mainly this image segmentation can be carried on two principles. Okay. So one is the first principle on which we can carry over the image segmentation is discontinuities. Okay, so based on the pixel intensities, we are going to identify those regions which can be considered as discontinuities. Based on those discontinuities, we are going to segment the given image. And the second criteria or the second principle on which we can perform the image segmentation is so called as similarity. Okay, so based on these discontinuities, there are so many different types we have to discuss. Like the first one is a point. Okay, so isolated points are extraction of points in a given image. And second one is line segmentation. Okay, and we have edge segmentation. So these are some of the techniques which can be applied using discontinuities. That is extraction of an isolated point, and we have extraction of a line segment, then as well as edge detection. So this can be carried out. Then on this similarity index, we have some of the thresholding. Okay, so segmentation based on threshold. So these are some of the techniques we have to discuss. Okay. So how to extract the isolated point? The first one is segmentation of isolated points. So how to get this isolated point? So isolated point means if there is any image, okay, you have an image. So here all the intensity levels, they are uniform. At one particular point, there may be a point or a dot. So this dot has to be segmented. So this dot has to be segmented. So that is called as isolated point. Okay. So in order to find out these isolated points, so we are going to use a mask. And this mask may be 3x3 size. So the mask may be like this, okay? A 3x3 mask can be used. Like we have W1, W2, W3, W4, W5, W6, W7, W8, and W9. This may be a 3x3 mask. And when you apply this 3x3 mask on an image, this may be an image Z1, Z2, they will indicate the pixels or intensities at a given particular point. Z2, Z3, Z4, Z5, Z6, Z7, Z8, and Z9. So this may be an image. Okay? So when you apply this mask, this entire mask on this particular image, so we have to multiply the intensity values and also we have to sum up them. Okay? So the response, the output of this will be given as a the response. So that is the response is equals to the response R is equals to summation from I is equals to 1 to 9. Okay. Summation I is equals to 1 to 9. Multiplication of mask WI into image. Okay, so this is the outcome. That is, so we have 9 values here, that is why it varies from 9. So this is the first mask, that is the mask. This will be applied on the entire image. So this will be given as a response, that is R. And if the response R, if it is always equal to 0, okay. If it is always equals to 0, it means whatever the point or the pixel what we have considered, it may not be a point. Okay. On the other hand, else, if R is any value which is not equal to 0, it may be any higher values. Okay. So in that particular situation, so there may be a variation in the intensity level. Okay. Since there is a variation in the intensity level, so it may be considered as a point. So in generally, so have you taken this? Show that I can draw. Can I draw this? Yes, students.
Yes, sir.
So in generally, so if you consider any image, already we tell you, no, there may be a point here. Okay. So the intensity levels, when you scan the image, it will be uniform in all the directions when you apply a 3x3 mask. Okay? So there is no variation. And once again, if you vary here, there is no variation. But when you apply the mask here, what happens? There is a variation. So that variation can be recorded as a response. And if it is not equal to 0, we will declare that the given point is a isolated point. Okay, so for in order to perform this, we are going to use a mask here. Okay, a 3x3 mask will be used in order to detect the isolated point. So -1, -1, -1, -1, -8, -1, -1, -1, -1. So this will be taken as a mask. Okay, and suppose if you are applied this mask on an image and all the intensity levels, they are uniform over there. Suppose if you have an image here. Okay, you know the image of that. Now you have the isolated point illa. And you are applying this mask on this image. So since there is no isolated point over here, all the intensity levels, all the pixels, they are uniform with respect to the gray levels. Hence, there is no variation. It means when you sum up all these things, -1, -1, -1, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7, -8, +8. So 8 + 8 - 8 is always equals to 0. So hence the response will be 0 because there is no variation in the intensity level. So on the other hand, suppose there may be a dot over here. Okay, and when you apply the mask here, okay, so then once again these values with respect to H, they will be multiplied with the intensity level present in the dot. So in this case, what happens, this value of response will be always not equal to zero, it may be something else. So hence we can declare that this will be taken as a isolated point. Got it? Yes. So this is the mask which is used for in order to detect the isolated point. Okay. Have you taken this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So similarly, if you go for line detection. Okay. So line detection is once again a technique in image processing in order to find out the line segments. Okay. Suppose if you have an image, so the image may contain lines. So this may be a horizontal line, there may be a vertical line, there may be oblique lines. Okay. So we have to find out these lines. So in order to find out these lines, once again we are going for a mechanism so called as line detection. So in order to detect this line, once again, we are going to use a special type of mask and of order 3x3. So this mask, okay, if you consider a 3x3 mask, so it is like this. So, like here, suppose if you consider lines, okay, there may be several types of lines, like we have horizontal lines. Okay, next we have vertical lines. So, if you want to detect horizontal lines, so the mask will be like this. So this 2, 2, 2, total sum is 6. 2 plus 2 plus 4 plus 2, 6. And if you sum up all these things, -1, -1, -1, -3, -1, -1, -3, -6. So +6, -6. Once again, total is normalized. It is 0. Suppose if you have an image, and this image contains a line like this. Okay. So this line, that is horizontal line. So when you apply this mask here, okay, so the line segment which are present here, 2, 2, 2, they will be carrying the higher value because there is a variation in the intensity value in this region. So that is why you are going to get a non-zero value as a response R. So hence this will be detected as a horizontal lines. So in order to detect the horizontal lines, this will be the mask. Now horizontal lines is over. Now if you want to detect the vertical lines, what about the vertical lines? So 2, 2, 2. So this will be the mask which is used to detect the vertical lines. Like this, if you have an image and you have a line like this, it's a vertical line, okay? Then, so when you apply the mask here, so this is 2, this is 2, this is 2, okay? So hence this is a line segment is present. The value should be taken, the response will be taken as non-zero. So that is why this will be detected as a vertical line. Arpan Rai go, mask go.
Yes, sir.
So now there may be oblique lines also, isn't it? There may be some oblique lines. In order to detect the oblique lines, special type of mask is used. So this is the line which is used to detect the 45 degree inclination lines, oblique lines. Like this, there may be a line in the image. This may be an image, okay, input image. This may be a mask. This is a mask, okay. So when you apply this mask on this image, what happens? Once again, it's a 3x3 mask. So in this region we have two. So the value, once again, the response will be of course not equal to zero. So this can be used to detect the that is with the oblique lines with the angle of 45 degree. Okay, have you taken this? Yes, Chalera?
Yes, sir.
So, if you consider the mask with another oblique line, that is like minus 45, what you can say? So, you have an input image. Input image may contains a minus 45 degree inclination line. So again, if you apply the mask, same thing happens. So this is 2, this is 2, this is 2. So once again, response will be not equals to 0. So it will be taken as an oblique line with the inclination angle of minus 45 degree. So this is how we can detect the line segments in a given image. So in edge detection, okay, so it is a combination of line detection and isolated points. Suppose if you have an image, okay, so only the outer parts, okay, so whenever there is a change in the intensity levels, for example, if you have a dark pixel here. So it's a dark pixel. So the image, it is totally dark. So on the other end, we have a white pixel over here. So now if you consider the intensity level, okay? So the intensity level, it is like this, okay? So if there is a, if this is going to be a black, then there is a sudden change in the, this is 255 degree level. So that is suddenly changed. When you scan this image, what happens? Up to all these regions, you have a black. So this will continue up to here. But when you reach this point, so this is an edge, what we can call edge. And this edge contains abrupt change in the intensity level. Suddenly, so there is a sudden skip here. Okay? This sudden skip, it is because of change in the intensity level from black to white. So this is white. So this is 255. Okay. So what are the, all the intensity values present here are white. So that is why it will continue in the 255 region. On the other hand, if you consider this, this is a zero region because it is black. Okay. So this type of edge detection can be identified by changes in the intensity level. Okay. Suppose it may be like this. Not exactly for the image. Like. So there may be a lighter shades, what you can say, grey colours, okay, light grey colour, not dark, not dark. In this scenario, the graph will be like this. Means there is a very slow, and this particular slope, it is so called as a slope. This is a slope, and the inclination of this slope, it depends on the gray level intensities present over here. If the gray levels means they contain all the values of low, that is zero, so the angle will be very, very less. On the other hand, if it contains more and more gray levels, then we are going more closer to 255. Because this slope, it is because of the there is a slow change in the intensity level. So that is why there is a what we can say, the graph is exponentially increasing here. On the other hand, if you consider this white and black, there is abrupt change. So this mechanism is called as edge detection. And if you consider this edge detection, there are two types of edge detection we can generally we can consider, like a Sobel operator, and we have Canny. So Sobel and Canny along with the Previct filter. They are used in edge detection. Okay. So these things about isolated points, line detection, and edge detection, I am going to explain a little bit more with the PDF, with the help of a PDF. Can you see this PPT, dear students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so image segmentation. So mathematical background. That is, segmentation means to divide the image into its component regions or objects. Segmentation is stopped when the objects of the interest in an application have been isolated. Means we can stop the process when our objective has been met. Means we are going to isolate particular region of interest. So these are some of the examples. This is the input image, okay, and this is a pre-processed image, and finally we are going to obtain the segmented image. So this intensity images, so what can I say, water segmentation, original gradient image, that is Sobel edge detection with a histogram equalization. Next, C is a raw watershed segmentation. So this is also a segmentation. It's called as a watershed segmentation. And D is a watershed segmentation using region markers to control some of the over segmentation. So if you consider the same thing what I have explained, there are two principal approaches in segmentation. Its segmentation is based on discontinuity and similarity. So discontinuity, so to partition the image based on the sharp changes in the intensity, is called as discontinuity principle approach. And similarly, we have similarity based segmentation. Here we are going to partition the image or region of interest into its constituent regions, that is based on the criteria, that is similarity, according to a set of predefined criteria. Among them, one is taken as a the thresholding. Okay. These are the fundamental definitions. So once again, it is related to image segmentation. So a more formal definition, that is, let R represent the entire image. Means suppose if R will be taken as an entire image, segmentation, it's a process that divides the R, R means original image, into n subregions, means n sub images, like R1, R2, so on up to Rn. When you combine R1, R2, Rn, you are going to get the original image R. So that is union of all these regions, 1 to n, it becomes original image. And Ri, okay, that is subdivided region, it's a connected set of each, either it may be one connected component 1, or it may be connected component 2, or so on up to n. And there may be no any common segmented regions. Okay, all the regions, they are distinct. There is no common or there is no similar segmented region. So that is why intersection of Ri and Rj is null set, means there should not be any two subregions or segmented regions which are same. Next, Q of R is equals to true for I is equals to 1 to n, and Q of R union Rj is equals to false for any adjacent regions, and here Q means it's a predicate. And then we get the rule anta. If the rule is satisfied, if the rule is true, then the regions will be segmented. On the other hand, if the rule is not satisfied with respect to the adjacent regions, they are not segmented. So this is the another output of segmentation. So image is the original image which containing some intensity, means it's a grayscale image, and this is P. Okay, you can see the light edges have been highlighted over here. You can see that. Okay, if you focus. So image showing the boundaries. Okay, next we have C, result of the segmentation. This is a combination of means we are going to fill the entire region inside this intensity, that is boundary. Then we have D, that is image containing texture region. So this is a texture region. We can fill the patterns inside that. Next, result of the edge computations. We are going to find out, we are going to bake it black and white or monotonically, or what you can say, binary image, by making the intensity levels as zero of this particular image. We are going to binarize this. Then we have finally the result, that is the segmented image. So next, so this is the first one, that is the detection of isolated point. Okay, so now you can see this is the entire image. This is going to be an entire image. In this image we have a point over here. Okay, so this is a point. Okay, this point is so called as isolated point. Okay, so how to detect this isolated point? So consider a line which has been drawn over here. This line will be represented by the function f of x, and this f of x is a one dimensional, because it never contains y component. If you consider the y component, it becomes two dimensional. So how to detect this? See here. So this is the original image. I am going to draw the intensity level graph or histogram. This is a histogram plot of intensities of this image. So when I'm going to draw this, so see here. So there is a decrease in the intensity levels, because all these regions where I'm pointing, they are black. Okay, initially it was white because this region is little bit white. So that is why it was high. But when you gradually come from left to right region, when you reach this place, all these regions are dark. So that is why it is going down. Means this value is zero and this value is 255. So the ground value is zero and the peak value is 255. And of course, all these regions are black. That is why it has reached to zero. But when you the scanning process continues, and when you encounter this point, this is isolated point. When you reach this particular point, what happens? There is a sudden increase in the peak. That is the graph has increased its number of intensity levels. It is the number of intensity level. It goes to 255 because this point is white. This point is white, hence there is a peak, sudden increase in the intensity level, and 255 you can notice over. This is because of the sudden increase in the change in the intensity level. Okay, and once you complete this, once again if you scan this image, once again the process continues, and once again this region is darker, hence the intensity level goes down once again to zero. And the process will continue until this region. This is a little bit gray, not pure white. It is gray. So that is why this is pure white. This is gray. No, so that is why half of the value will be taken here. That is this line. And once again, if you complete this line, once again the scan process continues, and all this region is black. So that is why it continues in the black. And when you reach this point, so this is also white region. So that is why the graph goes to back to peak, that is 255, and continues. So this is the histogram plot of the isolated point. So that is why the derivatives means there is a small increment in the or small change with respect to the function with respect to the isolated point. So we will use the derivatives, that is first and second, in order to discover the discontinuities, because isolated point is also one of the discontinuity. If we consider, if we observe a line with an image, we can consider it as a one-dimensional function. See, if you observe the line within the image, it can be considered as a one-dimensional function. If it is f of x, it is going to be one-dimensional. If it is f of x comma y, it should be two-dimensional. See here, this is the line, and this line will be going on the isolated point. So this will be, this function will be taken as f of x. Okay. So we will now define the first derivative simply as the difference between two adjacent pixels. So what is actually differentiation? Okay, differentiation is nothing but there is a small change with respect to the variable, and that can be, here the variables are nothing but the adjacent pixels. So dou f by dou x means with respect to the given function intensity level f, we are going to differentiate. F dash of x is the differentiation of adjacent pixels. F of x plus 1 and f of x, they are the adjacent pixels. And difference among them, that is the minus, that is the difference among them, will be taken as the differentiation, or what we can say, derivative. Next, this is the first order derivative. If you again differentiate the same function, you are going to get f dash of x, double dash of x. This is f dash of x, this is f double dash of x, because again we are going to differentiate the same function, that is by dou square by dou x square is equals to f of x plus 1. So now 2 times f of x will be get, so minus f of x, you are going to get minus 2 f of x plus f of x minus 1 and f of x plus 1, they are the two adjacent pixels. So that is first derivative generally produces thicker edges. So these derivatives, they are used to identify the thicker edges. Thicker means more and more what we can say, brighter. That those kind of regions we can call them as thicker edges. And second derivative, it is very, very strong. Even the small changes in the intensity level, it is going to notice. So that is why it is very strong response can be identified by using second order derivatives. And the second derivative sign can be used to determine the transition. Also here sign can be used, because I have explained why giving the line segmentation, line detection, plus 45, minus 45. So that is going to be the angle. The angle can be detected by using the direction. So this is the mask, the derivative computation. So the derivative is linear operator with respect to can be computed using the mask. For example, the mask for second derivative of x direction would be, which is the second order derivative for x. Next, we have detection of isolated points that I have already explained. So the fact that the second order derivative can be used very sensitive, that is why it is commonly used to detect as of course isolated points and as well as line detection. Along with the derivative, sometimes we are also going to use Laplacian operators. These Laplacian operators also I have explained in image transformations. Okay, so we will use Laplacian, which is the second order derivative over two dimensional function. So whatever the function with respect to isolated points we have taken, it is on one dimension. If you consider two dimension, that is f of, not f of x, but f of x comma y, in that situation we are going to use Laplacian operators. So this is the two dimensional function, that is f of x comma y. Okay, because we are taking another dimension. If the x represents row, y represents column. So that is dou square of f of x by dou x square plus dou square f of x y by dou y square, means differentiation with respect to x, with respect to rows, and differentiation with respect to y, that is column. Next. So now you consider this dou square f of x comma y by dou x square. So this will be taken. So this is nothing but f of x plus 1 plus y minus 2 f of x y plus f of x minus 1 comma y. See, notice down here, carefully observe whatever the things I am conveying here. So this is with respect to x, differentiation with respect to x. Differentiation when you are making with respect to x, there is a change in x only, there is no change in y. Y will be remained as it is. See, y
y. Only changes in the x, that is x plus 1, x and x minus 1. That is why it is differentiation with respect to x. Similarly, if you consider dou square f of x comma y by dou y square, this is change with respect to only y. So that is why you can see this y plus 1, y and y minus 1. On the other hand, x remains as it is. So this is the differentiation with respect to the column. So, and when you substitute this value in place of dou square f of xy by dou x square, and in place of dou square f of xy by dou y square, you substitute this value, you will have to perform the addition between these two. So minus 2, minus 2, it becomes minus 4 f of x comma y, and remaining thing we have to keep as it is. Okay. Dear students, are you getting? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now the detection of isolated points. So the isolated points, either you can go for the first order derivative or second order derivative. So this is the first order derivative, that is why they have taken minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. If you take second order derivative, it will be with respect to diagonal also. See, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 and minus 1, that is minus 4 plus 4. When you perform the normalization, the value will be, response will be 0. And if you place this mask on an input image, if it is a isolated point, the response will be not equals to 0 and can be detected as an isolated point. So we'll now decide about the threshold. Threshold means higher value, peak value, threshold T, that can be represented by the variable T, and any pixel whose value is larger than T, means whatever the values of the threshold and the intensity values what we have obtained, that is response, if that response R is greater than T, that is threshold, we can declare that the given point is isolated point. So this is the second order derivative, because here diagonal component can be also considered. On the other hand, this is only 4 neighbors, this is 8 neighbors. So that is why we have taken 8 as a response value. And the same thing what I have explained, this is the input image and this is the point which is isolated point. Okay, so if you want to detect this particular point, so we have to see here, we can notice down the output image, the dot has been detected over here. So the first image is a point detection mask, second one is the x-ray image of the turbine blade, and C is the result point of the detection. Okay, and this is the mask what we are going to use for detecting the isolated points. Similarly, line detection. So we can use the Laplacian also sometimes detection of line, since it is a sensitive to sudden changes. Laplacian means second order derivative. And we must note that since the second order derivative changes its sign on a line, it creates a double line effect, it must be handled. And second derivative can have negative results. Let us see what we were going to get here. So we have an input image over. This is an input image. So it contains varieties of line segments. This is this is going to be a vertical line, and this is going to be a horizontal line. So this is going to be a minus 45, and this is going to be a plus 45. Okay. So this is the output, that is a B Laplacian image, and C absolute value of the Laplacian, and positive values of the Laplacian. This is the outcome. So once again, the Laplacian is isotropic, that is independent of the direction. And if you would like to detect the line, these are some of the masks which are used to detect the line segments. In order to detect the horizontal lines, so this is the mask used, just whatever I have drawn on the board. And I already explained this. This is 45 degree plus 45 degree. And this is vertical, because this is a 222 will be here. If the 222 is present here, it is horizontal. If it is present like this, it will be a vertical. And this is minus 45 degree and this is plus. So this mask already I have written on the board. So this is the result. Okay. So binary wire bond mask. Okay, that is the original image. Absolute value of the result after processing to minus 45 degree. So this is the outcome of minus 45 degree. That is why you can see this line segment is highlighted. You can see this line segment. it is minus 45. It has been highlighted. Okay, result of the thresholding. Thresholding means only highest peak value will be retained. Rest of the things will be ignored or they will be erased. So this is the threshold value, higher peak values. Means only the line segment which is minus 45 degree will be highlighted, and all the other, we have plus 45 degree, so they will be eliminated using the thresholding. So this is the segmentation, line segmentation using second order derivative or Laplacian operators. Again, in edge detection, we have step edge, ramp edge, and roof edge. There are three types of edge detection we can explain. So the first one is a step edge. Step means just like a step, okay, sudden abrupt change in the intensity levels. So transition of intensity levels over one pixel are ideal, or few pixels will be taken as a step edge. Ramp edge. Ramp is just like a slope, okay? So a slow graduate transition means the graph which is exponentially increasing is considered as a ramp edge. Similarly, we have a roof edge, that is a transition at a different intensity and back. Suddenly, for example, isolated point, suddenly there is an increase in the intensity levels and immediately there is a drop in the intensity levels. You can see the diagram, then you can come to know this. See? So this is the example for the first one, that is step edge, okay, step. So this is step, you can see. So this is already I have drawn on the board. This is entirely black region and this is entirely white region. So the intensity level goes like this, uniformly up to black, and when you encounter a edge, this is the edge. So there is a sudden increase in the intensity level from 0 to 255. From there on, once again, it will continue because all the regions are white. On the other hand, if you consider a ramp edge, so there is a gradual, slow increase in the whiteness. So this is total black, this is total white, and this is in between, gray. So that is why the graph is exponentially increasing, and this exponentially increase can be identified by the slope. Then the third one is the roof edge. So we can see a line over here, okay? So this left region and right region, they are purely black. So that is why the intensity are at the zero level. And when you encounter this region, there is a peak. There is a peak. So there is a peak here. Oh, and this peak decreases because once again, there is a decrease in the intensity level and we are continuing with the black region. So these are the three types of edge models. So, and these edge models can be used for performing the profiling. So two regions separated by a vertical edge. This is an A, vertical edge, B. So detail near the edge showing the gray level profile and the first and the second order derivative of the profile. So this is the first order, this is the slope. Okay, the slope indicates there is a gradual change. There is a gradual change. You can notice the difference here. This particular region indicates the edge. There is an edge over here. And this edge is not abrupt, or what we can say, step edge. This is a little bit closer to ramp edge. So that is why you can notice down there is a slow change in the intensity level. So that is why the graph is exponentially increasing. So this first order derivative is like this. This is the first order derivative. Second order derivative is like this. So this is the graphical or diagrammatic representation of the first order and second order derivative of the edge profiles or edge models. So you can also see the sensitivity of this graph. So if you consider a very clear image, crystal clear image, and of course it is a ramp edge because there is a slow increase here. And of course this is a step edge model because there is abrupt change and it is very, very clear. So this is second order derivative. So already I have told that. Now a little bit of noise. If you add a little bit of noise to the original image, so this is the original image. So what happens in case of the step edge, you can notice this is the noise, okay? Okay, and similarly in second order derivative, it is very, very sensitive to the noise because hence there is a lot of changes in the peak. And if you add more and more noise, once again, there is a change in first order derivative also. And of course, second order derivative is very, very harsh and visible noise. Even the graph whatever the graph or that is the ramp edge is also contains some of the noise features, and there is a huge change in the peak of the intensity levels with respect to second order derivative ones. So this is all about the edge models. Okay, so I'll continue my class in the next class. So till then, if you have any doubts, you can ask. Let me execute this and check. Okay, I'm going to share the MATLAB window. Can you see the MATLAB window, dear students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the code I have taken. So lab 10.1 is the input image, and I am applying this mask. Can you see the mask here? So this mask is used to detect the isolated points -1, -1, -1, -1, -8, -1, -1, -1. This mask is used to detect the isolated point. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm going to apply this using IM filter, image filter, double the value of input image, that is F, with respect to the mask. And T is equals to, T means threshold, maximum of G. All the intensities alli yavudu maximum irutho adu threshold anta tagontivi, G which is greater than threshold will be highlighted. So we have here original image and result of the point detection. So here do we that. So check marana. I am executing this now. It is busy. Really, it is under execution. Okay, and getting the output. So you can notice down this point will be taken here. Arthathidya, point one kaanista ide nimage ili?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is the original image, and only single isolated point will be detected over here. So this is called point detection. So okay, I'm going to stop here. I request all of you to give your attendance. Okay, dear students, thank you for joining my session. I request all of you to give your attendance in the chat box. If you have any queries or doubts, kindly ask, dear students. No doubts? Shall we stop here?
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much for joining MES Processing Class.